Fine, Yuvraj.
है।
Tell me about yourself, Yuvraj, first, then we'll start.
I just passed out of 12th
With
and
PCI. With PCI.
PCI, yes, PCI, and I'm passionate about being a pilot.
That's great. That's very good.
He is passionate since he was in seventh or eighth
Seventh,
class. He
yes.
decided
Oh,
that he wanted to become a pilot.
that's
So
great.
he's
See,
passionate since then.
unfortunately, we don't have any flying school in Ujjain anymore.
Yeah.
Yes, there
Otherwise,
was, yes, I.
at one time, we used to have India's best, one of the best and biggest flying school in Ujjain.
Oh, I was not knowing that.
Yes, here you used to be India's one of the best and biggest flying school.
Yeah, he told me sometime
Huh.
back, yeah.
Yes,
He was
still
there.
they have their aircrafts lying there. They had around 15-20 aircrafts. And they were running
Okay.
very good shows. I don't know what happened to them.
Continue.
Your voice is breaking, Paridhi.
Yeah.
ये माइक्रोफोन के लिए,
Yeah, is it audible now?
यस, नाउ इट्स परफेक्ट।
Yeah.
यस
So continue.
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन फर्स्ट एंड देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू,
Yeah,
है
sure.
ना? यू स्टार्ट योर क्वेश्चंस।
Start.
फर्स्ट आई वांट टू नो अबाउट इट इज बेटर टू डू इन इंडिया और आउटसाइड इंडिया द पायलट ट्रेनिंग।
That's a very good question. Basically, see, it depends upon you. If you can afford, then of course the foreign training is always better than Indian.
Okay.
But that depends upon your affording, basically.
Is it more expensive abroad, or
It is
I
little
think
more
the
expensive, of course.
pilots?
It is little more expensive, but more exposure also you will get there.
Okay.
Okay, but what we studied over the internet and all stuff, like the foreign training is little cheaper than
Cheaper
in
than
India.
India.
That what
It is
we
not possible. I
got
mean,
through.
see, practically you can see it's not possible. Because see, if you are
Okay.
doing your training in abroad, definitely you have to visit that place couple of times.
Yes, definitely.
So that cost will always increase.
Yeah.
Living is Acha, secondly, abroad we cannot term as a one place. There are
Right.
more than
Are
100
there like any
countries.
many
There are
countries?
more than 100 countries which provide flying training.
Okay.
Acha.
But we'll go for the best one.
This the best one, though we cannot afford, to be very honest. Indians can't
Okay.
afford the best one. Best one like is possible only in US, UK, Canada, these three places, and they are filthy
Okay.
expensive. Until unless you don't have the resident like a visa for these places or the immigration for these places, I'll never suggest you to go for these places during this time.
Okay.
Okay.
So
But there are
Canada, how much cost comes, like what is the estimate if you want to go to Canada?
Canada. Average cost for the normal CPL, CPL, IR, and multi-engine rating is comes around 60,000 Canadian dollar as of now.
Okay.
Hai na? That is the basic cost, plus living and other expenses would be top of that. So we'll not talk about that thing right now. Secondly, the most important problem with the Canada is the visa. Getting Canadian visa first time is really very difficult.
Oh, that we will
I
not
didn't
know.
know that.
है ना? अच्छा, अप्लाइंग फॉर अ कैनेडियन वीजा एंड गेट द पेपर वर्क डन इटसेल्फ इज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव. दैट टेक्स अबाउट 1 लाख ऑफ रुपीज और 2 लाख रुपीज. एंड इफ यू डोंट द वीजा दैट मनी विल गॉन.
Yeah, if you
है
don't get it, yeah, it is not refundable. Yeah, that's
ना?
correct.
सो नॉर्मली आई डोंट सजेस्ट पर्सन दोज हु डोंट हैव द वीजा ऑलरेडी वीजा और द इमिग्रेशन थिंग्स डन. If you already
ओके
have any kind of Canadian visa or US visa, then तो it's okay. Then definitely you are right, it may be cheaper also.
Okay.
And there are cheaper places in US, Canada, and other places, but to get into those places is very difficult.
Okay.
Because
So
the
there are some sort of entrance
probability of getting visa for
exams.
such places is very less as compared to getting the
Okay.
visa from the better schools.
Okay.
For those who are already having visa or immigration, they can always go for that kind of a school and get it done And the quality of those schools is also good. It's not that bad. But price is quite economic.
And then
Secondly,
from the
what happens
same
is,
college we can apply for jobs as well.
yes. Secondly, what happens is when you are doing your frank training in US, Canada kind of countries, you always do some part-time jobs as well. That is
That we
the
have to do.
culture, that is the culture there. So at least you earn some living. But right now, since we don't have that visa and all, so we'll not take the chance for that kind of places. We'll prefer to go for a country like Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines,
Voice is breaking.
Africa, Sri Lanka. These are the places where you get the better, cheaper training. And like visa is also not that difficult.
Can you rename the countries? Your voice is being green.
Like we can plan for Philippines, Malaysia, Singapore, Sri Lanka, Maldives, or South Africa, that kind of countries.
Because basically what we wanted to know is if it is better in India or
India,
outside, like what should
Indian
we
training is not at all good. To be very honest, personally, I
we're
never
not
tried.
able to hear you.
Actually, your voice is breaking. I mean,
Not
I
able
think
to
you
hear
disconnect.
you.
Hello, can you hear me? No?
Internet off.
I can hear you now. Can you hear me?
We're not able to hear you.
Hello? Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Is it better? Hello? 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 Can you do one thing? Can you just log in with your secondary device as well?
Hello.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, if it
So the
also
best thing, best possible thing is like either we can go to Sri Lanka or we can go to Philippines.
Philippines.
Yeah, Philippines is kind of capital of aviation nowadays.
Okay.
But don't make one mistake which normally every pilots in India doing. What they do is as soon as they finish their frank training in Philippines, they immediately come back to India and try to get their license converted. So don't keep yourself like confined to Indian market. Indian market is not big enough, है ना? तो मेक योर सेल्फ इंटरनेशनल पायलट एंड कीप योर सेल्फ ओपन फॉर एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड वेर एवर यू गेट चांस बिकॉज विथ योर फिलीपीन सीपीएल यू कैन अप्लाई एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया. सो इफ यू गेट एनी चांस इन फिलीपींस इटसेल्फ आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ योर सीपीएल डोंट डोंट कम बैक टू इंडिया इमीडिएटली. डोंट बी इन हरी टू कम बैक टू इंडिया. दैट इज द बिगेस्ट मिस्टेक. क्योंकि क्या होता है जब आप 200 आवर्स या 220 आवर्स 250 आवर्स ऑफ फ्लाइंग के साथ इंडिया जाते हो तो लाइसेंस कन्वर्जन थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट हो जाता है.
And there are no small airlines in India. Only big airlines are there.
एग्जैक्टली. सो इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर कि यू गेन सम एक्सपीरियंस देयर ओनली वर्क एज अ फ्लाइट इंस्ट्रक्टर और मे बी चार्टर पायलट और मे बी फेरी पायलट क्योंकि फिलीपींस इज अ काइंड ऑफ कैपिटल ऑफ एविएशन. गेन एटलीस्ट 1500 आवर्स 2000 आवर्स ऑफ फ्लाइंग एक्सपीरियंस. ट्राई टू गेट योर एटीपीएल ऑल्सो बिकॉज कन्वर्टिंग एटीपीएल इज मच इजियर देन कन्वर्टिंग द सीपीएल. ओके एंड देन कम बैक टू इंडिया. फिलीपींस में नहीं मिल रहा है मलेशिया चले जाओ पास में ही है ब्रुनोई चले जाओ सिंगापुर चले जाओ. देर आर मेनी कंट्रीज नियर बाय ओनली इंडोनेशिया है वहां चले जाओ या फिर गल्फ कंट्री पूरा खुला है.
गल्फ कंट्री बट गल्फ कंट्रीज इज ऑल्सो एक्सपेंसिव. दुबई
अरे
का देखा
जॉब
था.
के लिए जॉब
अच्छा
के
लिए
जॉब के लिए. ओके
सो
ओके
आफ्टर
ओके
कंप्लीटिंग योर ट्रेनिंग यू कैन
यू
अप्लाई फॉर
कैन
जॉब्स इन ऑल दीस अदर
इवन इवन कंट्रीज लाइक नेपाल श्रीलंका दे हैव लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर इंडियन पायलट्स. यू कैन गो देयर है ना.
ओके So what is the cost, like any university you know of Philippines where we can apply?
I can help you. Yes, Philippines, I can help you with some of the good universities.
Okay. And what is the average cost of that country?
Around $55,000 to $60,000.
Okay.
Okay.
US dollars. US dollars.
Okay. So it will include everything. Like you wanted to have some other nationals as well.
What about the type rating?
Typewriting is not included in any of these courses.
Okay.
Typewriting you can do in Philippines itself. There are a good typewriting institute also. Typewriting would cost you another $20,000. But I would suggest you to go for typewriting immediately. Better do the instructor rating rather than the typewriting.
Okay.
Get some experience, because like with 250 hours of flying, if you are going for typewriting, it's very difficult to do the typewriting.
Okay.
And with 300 hours of flying or 400 hours of flying or at least 500 hours of flying with some flying like instructional experience, if you go for type rating, you will learn better.
Okay. So it is not like you have to compulsory do type rating, otherwise you will not get much options in the job. Like
ऐसा
नहीं होगा, right? So with CTP
type rating में क्या होता है? Type rating का एक जो disadvantage है वो क्या होता है? Suppose if you are type rated on a Airbus 320, and if there is a vacancy for Boeing 737,
you will not be able to do
that. You are as good as the non-type rated pilot.
Okay.
Because again, you have to get the entire type rating on that
for
particular,
that particular pilot. Maybe,
maybe ATR 72. So you never know किस aircraft की type rating आ, किस aircraft की openings आ रही है.
Okay.
Second thing, type rating is valid for 6 months only, initial type rating.
I know that.
After 6 months, again, you have to go for renewal.
So again, we have to spend another $20,000 for getting
the No, no, not complete, not complete.
Okay.
Just the couple of hours you have to fly.
Okay.
And जो type rating होती है वो actual aircraft पर नहीं होती है.
Okay.
Simulators पर होती है, but those simulators are very sophisticated. They are as good as the actual aircraft.
Mm-hmm.
And the cost of those simulator is more than the cost of the aircraft.
Okay.
So you can imagine ke how expensive and how sophisticated. They are very state of the art machines.
Okay.
And you actually learn flying on those aircraft, those simulators only.
Okay.
And Philippines is equipped with all those kind of aircraft, those kind of machines.
Okay. Okay, so we will be targeting only Philippines or other like Malaysia, Singapore also we can have a look.
Malaysia, Singapore, we have very limited scope these days.
Okay.
Only very few flying academies are there.
Okay.
And they are little bit more expensive than Philippines.
Okay. And once completing the training, we can apply for job from the same university will help in finding the jobs like we have
in
India.
There are universities actually for flying training. There are small aviation companies.
Okay.
So these companies normally they have the charter division, they have the air ambulance divisions or maybe some other divisions. So you can always go for that. But there is no surety. If you are a very good pilot, if you are very safe pilot, then only there are chances to get the job.
Okay. Okay. And from the same academy wherever you are joining.
But if you are nearby, there are many companies are there on the nearby airports.
Mm-hmm.
But everything depends upon you, how good you are with your link building.
Okay. So how you perform basically if you're the top among the top pilots.
At one hand you have to improve your performance, you have to show your performance, at the same time you have to build your own contacts also, your relations also.
Okay. So once the training is completed, you can nearby you can apply for the jobs as well.
Not at the end of the completion of the training. Once you are done with the 150 hours or 160 hours, you can start searching.
Okay.
It's not that easy ki you are done with the course and you will get the job immediately.
Okay.
So it's always better to start 2-3 months in advance. So by the time you will get your license done, you will do the formalities to joining.
Okay.
Got it.
And
secondly, you have to get a good part-time job as well.
There in the Philippines.
Very important. Very, very important. That may stretch your flying training little longer.
Okay.
The normal duration is around 12 months at an average, but that may stretch your training for 15 months or maybe 18 months, but that's worth.
Okay.
Because if you are doing a job in a local nearby area in any field, not only in aviation, any job, at least you are building your contacts, local contacts.
Okay. Right.
You are getting scope to stay back there for longer time. So suppose immediately after finishing your frank training, you are not getting a job immediately.
Mm-hmm.
In aviation itself, at least you can survive there and you can find out a job in aviation.
Okay. Yeah, well, if you are having local contacts, it will be
easy. That helps you a lot.
Yeah. Okay. So that will be great.
Secondly, you have to have a very good, strong connection with Indian Embassy, Indian High Commissions.
Okay.
That is also very important. These guys also help you a lot in many ways.
Okay. Only the Indian Embassy people.
Indian Embassy. Because what happens in Indian Embassy, Indian High Commission, there are some festivals.
Right.
You at least go and join those festivals. Be part of that.
Mm-hmm. So you will be getting contacts.
Yes. Not directly, but indirectly, definitely that helps you.
Okay. Yeah, definitely. So
these small, small tips you have to follow when you are doing your training abroad.
Yeah, definitely. One more thing, the question was, so he will be going, he has just completed his 12th, now he will be going, so there will be no graduation in between. So there's another option.
What I would suggest you for that thing is, let him do graduation by correspondence or distance learning or anything.
Okay.
That's very important. Secondly, if he can join some university there for the graduation as well,
mm-hmm.
that is always a plus point. Universities are very, very inexpensive there. Like doing the BBA or that kind of courses,
mm-hmm.
or maybe normal BA, BCom kind of courses there, it's very easy.
Okay.
But that will help him a lot in many ways.
Okay.
So he has got two choices. One, so he can join any online course.
Distance learning.
Distance learning or correspondence or any course in India itself.
Okay.
Secondly, one more course he can join once he is there.
Okay. So that will give him some benefit.
He will get 3 years to stay back there, right. Even after his flying training.
Right. So he can search jobs.
He can search
doing
a job and he can do a lot of things.
Yes.
On the basis of that.
And it will be having a plus point if you are having a degree
always,
from there.
Always a plus point. And he will get a good local contacts, local friend circle.
Right. Hmm. Okay, so we got many options to become a pilot. So when we search over internet, first thing is
after
12.
Always confusing. Internet
yeah,
is
that is for sure. We are very confused. That's why we approached
you. I wrote a book. If you want, you can order that book. It's available on Amazon. So from that, those points only from the internet, I have summarized everything in a very simplified way, step by step.
Okay. Because some people do a degree in aviation from India and then they go for a training. So that is BSc in aviation or BTEC.
Nothing is required. Nothing is required.
Okay.
See, that always help it. That's not a thing. That always help, but that's not the right way.
Okay.
It's always better to start your training as early as possible.
Yeah, because the age limit is there.
There is no age limit as such.
Mm-hmm.
I have seen many pilots, they start their career at the age of 30, 35.
Okay.
That's not an issue.
Okay.
But still, it's always better.
Okay. Any questions?
And
if you want to do in India, like one option is like going to Philippines.
Right.
If
right.
you want to do in India, what is the estimate? Or any universities?
See, India the best is IGRUA only, Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Udan Academy.
Bareilly.
That is the best place in India.
Okay. So that is a government institute.
That's a kind of government. I mean, yes, you can say it's a government.
Okay. So we might be having
they have two or three branches now.
Okay.
So it's always better to apply through that. But their admission procedure is very bad. Secondly, it's very frustrating to do flying training in India. हमेशा कुछ ना कुछ इश्यूज होते ही होते हैं कभी स्पेशली व्हेन यू आर नॉट फ्रॉम द एविएशन बैकग्राउंड व्हेन यू आर द फर्स्ट जनरेशन पायलट इफ यू आर पायलट फ्रॉम द लाइक सेकंड थर्ड जनरेशन देन थिंग्स बिकम इजी
एंड व्हाट अबाउट द यू नो प्राइवेट एयरलाइंस डूइंग दैट कोर्स इंडिगो कैडेट प्रोग्राम और
दैट्स वेरी वेरी
अराउंड अ करोड़ आई 1 करोड़
दैट इज वन थिंग सेकंडली यू नेवर नो अबाउट दीस एयरलाइंस एज क्रेडिबिलिटी नाउ
Okay.
Lot of students applied for Jet Airways cadet pilot program in last 3 years, 4 years, and they are at nowhere now. After spending 60, 70 lakh rupees, they are gone.
Okay.
सेकेंडली यू बिकम कन्फाइंड टू वन पर्टिकुलर एयरलाइंस. अगर आपके उसमें अगर आप ट्रेनिंग प्रोसीजर और उसके वो सब पढ़ेंगे, फाइन प्रिंट्स पढ़ेंगे, तो यू विल कम टू नो इफ यू मेक अ स्मॉल मिस्टेक दे विल पुट यू आउट फ्रॉम द ट्रेनिंग. दे आर वेरी स्ट्रिक्ट. That's a very good option for those who are already from the aviation background. If you are a captain with Indigo Airlines and if you are doing a cadet pilot program with the Indigo, it's good for you. Like, okay. If your parents are captain or parents are aircraft maintenance engineer.
Oh,
or
okay, anything. Okay. That, on
so
that
for,
way.
For the kids of those airlines, airlines professionals, things are pretty easy.
Okay, but if you're a first generation, it will be difficult.
It is really difficult.
Yeah. Because that was the concern. Because if we do a training in India, then we should get that many options to do job. Because Indigo is very expensive, so we have to go with the local, the government, and all. So that after the training, getting jobs will be difficult in India.
That is all. What's your parents doing basically?
My father is having a medical shop in Ujjain.
Pharmacy.
Nobody is from an aviation background.
No one. That's why he is the first person in the entire family to go in such a background. So that's why we are very confused. And we are very
we need to get lot of difficulties initially.
Yes. He is getting now from now itself.
So that will always be there.
Okay.
So he has.
Okay, so we'll go for the Philippines then. How to go forward? We need your guidance in that.
That I'll help. Don't worry.
Yes. Okay. So the universe.
The right persons.
Mm-hmm.
They will guide you step by step. Follow their instructions clearly. In case if you don't find any problem, any difficulty, then you can talk to them.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much.
But before taking any step with them also. Or with any academy, please cross check with me or any of the pilot.
Okay.
Yeah, no? With all your documentation, everything. Mm-hmm. Don't do anything in hurry, no matter what. Yeah,
okay.
No?
Okay.
Take every step very carefully. Achha, what about your passport and all? Is it ready?
Yeah, passport is there.
Passport is there.
Okay. How about the immigration status on the passport? ECNR?
No, that is not done.
That is not done.
Okay.
So you will get how about your parents' passport? Do they have the passport?
No, they don't have. Only my sister has.
I'm having.
No, that won't help. Because parents are having the passports with the ECNR, so to get the ECNR will become very easy.
Okay. We can they have applied, but some of the documents were missing, so the passport verification didn't go through. So that was the problem. So they have applied twice.
First thing what he can do is let him get his medical done.
Yeah, yes. That's the first step.
That is a very first step, because at least he should know whether he's medically fit or not. Secondly, he has to start with the basic things. Do you do the cycling?
No, I do exercise.
Cycling, running, or swimming?
No.
Do you know swimming? If possible, learn swimming.
Okay.
During this. And start cycling in the morning and the evening. Maybe 15 minutes a day, 30 minutes a day.
Okay.
If you can do 30 minutes a day, cycling two times a day, and if you don't find any difficulty, like you can see yourself fresh and energetic. That means 99% you are medically fit. It's a thumb rule basically.
Okay.
Okay.
After that, only the eye thing is there. So get your eye checkup done, especially with your color blindness and the eyesight.
Okay.
Eyesight has to be 6x6, with or without a spec.
Okay. 6x6.
So these things you have to get it done first.
Okay.
Okay.
And maybe you can check, get your ENT checkup done with the medical doctor.
Okay.
You'll get a basic idea.
Yes. Okay.
But cycling is the best thing to check yourself. If you can do cycling for 30 minutes continuously, maybe after a week or so, means after practicing for a week or 10 days, that means you are medically fit.
Okay.
to fly an aircraft.
Okay. So we'll do these steps, and then you guide us with like what colleges to apply for, and we can take from there forward. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Anything else?
You want to ask anything else?
Nothing. I got my answers.
You got your answers for sure?
Yes.
He was very confused because what he was thinking is there's a college in Pune, so from there he can do a BSc in aviation, and then he can opt for a flight school like that. So that was his plan.
That's not a bad option,
okay.
But that will delay his delay his basic career.
Okay.
That would help him a lot.
Okay.
But that's not a bad option also. At least he'll have the backup.
Yes. So once he is doing his BSc in aviation, he will be having other options except from pilot.
Exactly.
Because he wanted to go in that field only. मतलब इसका ऐसा है कि pilot नहीं बनूंगा, but अगर उस field में कुछ होगा तो I'm very happy. But I don't want to switch my field. He want to go in that direction only.
Correct. Because see, it's a pandemic time, है ना? और वैसे भी don't plan your flying training before June, July of this year.
Okay.
Take that much of time for your preparation.
Okay. So the universities which you are suggesting, so there might be some entrance exams for that, or?
ऐसा जैसा कोई entrance exam नहीं होता, they will just take the telephonic exam, the telephonic test.
Okay.
It's basically.
Some basic questions.
English test होता है, spoken English. Then you are good to go.
Okay.
The documentation. Visa process, but things are pretty slow these days due to this pandemic and all. So do plan your training before July.
June, July. Okay.
Join July onwards course only.
Okay.
So you will have ample of time, sufficient time to
prepare myself.
And meanwhile, join any graduation course.
Okay.
Maybe correspondence, maybe distance learning, maybe open school, whatever you want.
Okay.
And plan one more course once you are landed there.
Okay. So, वहाँ से भी you can do one course, and from here also you can do whatever you are willing to, so that it will be easy. So, if suppose he is doing BSc in aviation as a distance learning program in from India, so what are the options after that? Like, even if you're not becoming
there is no much option with the normal graduation degree.
Okay.
But at least graduation to hai. At least he can go for masters.
Right.
Okay.
Because without masters nowadays, it's very difficult to get any job.
Okay.
Except engineering and all, engineering or medical.
Right. After engineering.
But even with the engineers nowadays.
No, it's not that easy.
Not that easy to.
Yeah. No.
I mean, you are fortunate enough to get into such a good brand immediately, but that's not very common nowadays.
Yeah. Nowadays it's not that common. It's very
right.
difficult to get into big industries. Because my parents think is, so if we are suppose spending 50-60 lakhs on his graduation or on training, then we should have some return in back. There's some job security kind of thing. Like, agar pilot nahi bana, so something he can do in that field.
That is what backup we have to keep, and that is the reason I don't want him to come back immediately after his flying training.
Okay.
That is the reason I want him to stay back there, at least get a small job, whatever job he's getting there. Gain some experience of flying and then come back.
Yeah, that will be easy for him.
And I'm sure you are not going to take the education loan kind of things.
No.
Then, because that is very important.
Okay.
It's always better to go for your own expenses.
Okay. Sure.
कैसे
पता लगा फिलिपिन आप बता
देंगे Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you. Bye. Have a nice day.